Hello, I am Professor N.B. Hulle, and this is the third video in the series of the lectures on calculation of the different parameters using the Smith chart. Here, this is a typical example in which we are planning to calculate input impedance of two transmission lines connected in parallel at their sending end. The first line has the characteristic impedance of this much 400 ohm and terminated by 800 ohm, and second transmission line has a characteristic of 400 ohm and terminated by this 400 plus j 400 ohm, and the length of the first transmission line is 5 lambda by 8 and length of the second transmission line is 3 lambda by 8. Here, how is our plan? In this case, we are the architecture of the transmission line is something like this. Here we have the first transmission line terminated by the impedance, which is I will call it as ZR1 for the first transmission line, and here the second transmission line is something like this, having the characteristic impedance of 400 and terminated by the another impedance, I will call it as ZR2 here. And we are interested to calculate input impedance of the parallel combination using the Smith chart. How is the plan? Now first we will calculate the sending end impedance, that is ZS1, that is input impedance of the first transmission line using Smith chart. Similarly, we will calculate the input impedance of the second transmission line, which is ZS2 here. Then we will convert these impedances into the admittances, which is I will call it as Y1 or YS1 here, that is sending end impedance of the first transmission line and sending end impedance of the second transmission line. And then we are in a position to calculate the total admittance of the transmission line. This is a simple mathematical calculation. And then we will take its calculate its value of the impedance, which is ZS, that is input impedance of this parallel combination. This is YS, that is admittance of the parallel combination. This is my plan, and the procedure is again common here. First we have to normalize both impedances, that is Z1, which is normalized value is 2 plus j0, and Z2, the normalized value is 1 plus j1. Here I will show how to calculate these input impedance of the parallel combination of this transmission line here. As I have mentioned here, this is the given data. First transmission line has the Z1 as a load impedance, and second transmission line has Z2 as a load impedance, which is normalized value. Length of the first transmission line is 0.625 lambda, and length of the second transmission line is 0.375 lambda. We will begin with the calculation of the input impedance of the first transmission line. For that, we have to plot this value on the Smith chart, which is the normalized value, which is the intersection of j is equal to 0 and real value. Means here, if I am finding here, real value is here and j is equal to 0 is on this particular line, is this point will be that load point. Something like this. This is the load Z1 having the value of 2 plus J0. Then we will draw the S circle by taking the center of the circle as the center of the Smith chart, and we will draw the circle. Then we will project this value on the outside margin, and then we will rotate towards generator, because here in this case, if we are calculating the input impedance of the first transmission line, here this value is ZR1, which we have plotted already, which is this value. And to calculate its input impedance, which is ZS1, we are traveling towards the generator. We are traveling towards the generator, means on the Smith chart from this particular point, we have to travel in the clockwise direction, because towards generator is nothing but clockwise direction on the Smith chart, by the distance of 0.625 lambda. But here 0.5 lambda is nothing but one complete rotation on the Smith chart. Means how we will plot or how we will travel by the distance of the 0.625 lambda. Here, in this case, this 0.5 lambda means one complete rotation, means this value is very same as, this value is very same as the 0.5 plus that is 0.125 or sorry, it is 0.625 here to be exact. And this is 0.5 plus 0.125, this is 0.125, means here this distance is nothing but one complete rotation, and effective traveling will be 0.125 only. Means from this particular point we have to travel by the 0.125 lambda, and then we have to project this value somewhere here. We will read out its coordinate, that will give the value of the ZS1, which I will show something like this. Center of the Smith chart, as the center of the circle, we are drawing the S circle, then we are extending this point on the outside of the Smith chart, which is outer rim on which the distance is available in terms of the wavelength. And here we are traveling by only the 0.125. Here the care has to be taken because this 0.625 is nothing but 0.5, that is one complete rotation, and effective rotation will be 0.125. And then we will read out the coordinate here, and that will give the input impedance of the first transmission line. This is the input impedance of the first transmission line, and then we will convert this impedance into the admittance. This is the admittance of the first transmission line, which is 0.8 plus j0.6 is the admittance of the first transmission line. Then here we will deal with the second transmission line, which is having the load impedance of this much value and length is of the 0.375. The process is again, or procedure is again the same, plot the load impedance and then travel by this much distance in the clockwise direction, because in this case also, the available value is the ZR2, that is load impedance of the second transmission line, and we are planning to calculate the input impedance or sending end impedance of the second transmission line. Means we have to travel towards the clockwise, towards the generator, means on the Smith chart we need to travel in the clockwise direction by the given distance of the transmission line, which is in this case is the 0.375 lambda, which is something like this. Here we are plotting the second impedance, which is 1 plus J1 on the Smith chart. Then we are drawing the S circle, then we will extend this particular point, outside margin, and we will travel here by the distance of that is 0.375 again in the clockwise direction, because we have to move towards the generator. Means we are extending this point and then we are traveling toward the generator, which is on the Smith chart in the clockwise direction. Then we will shift that particular point somewhere here, and we will read out its coordinate here. In this case, this value is the characteristic, the input impedance of the second transmission line. Again, we will calculate its admittance, and this is the admittance of the second transmission line. Now, what we have here, we have the four things. Now here, this is the input impedance of the first transmission line. Here, the input impedance of the second transmission line. And this is the input admittance of the first transmission line, and here this is the input admittance of the second transmission line. What we will do here, we will find out the total admittance, which is Y, by using simple mathematics, which is nothing but the input impedance of the first transmission line, which is YS1, plus input impedance of the second transmission line, which is YS2, that is sending end impedance of the second transmission line. We will get the total admittance, that is Y. We will plot somewhere here, and then we will convert into the impedance, and we are able to calculate its final value, something like this. This is simple mathematical calculation. Y is equal to Y1 plus Y2, where Y1 is sending end admittance of the first transmission line, and Y2 is the sending end admittance of the second transmission line. And if we are doing the simple calculation here, the real part is added with real in case of the complex number, which is 2 plus 0.8, which is 2.8. This plus 0.6 J minus J is nothing but minus 0.4 J is the effective value. We will plot it, which is somewhere here. We will plot this particular value, which is intersection of the 2.8 circle and minus 0.J circle. Minus it is because it is it need to be plotted below the axis. And then we will convert this impedance to the this admittance to the impedance, and we will read out this value. And here in this case, This is the final value of the admittance, final value of the admittance of this parallel combination, which is something like this here. What we have done here, this is the first transmission line, then we have, this is the second transmission line, and we have calculated its input impedance of the first transmission line, input impedance of the second transmission line, then we have calculated its admittance, we have added its admittance, and then finally we have converted the final admittance into the impedance to calculate its final effective value, which is thus in this particular example. Means this, these are the tricks to dealing with the transmission line. Here I will go for another example. Sometimes we have complications in the simple assignments. This is Zin, that is input impedance of the transmission line. I will go for another example here. In this example, the here lossless transmission line having the characteristic impedance 70 ohm is terminated by the open circuit. Sometimes the lines are terminated by the open circuit or short circuit. In that particular case, for the different values of the lengths of the transmission line, in this case it is lambda by 8, lambda by 4, 3 lambda by 8, and it is lambda by 8, 3 lambda by 8. I guess something is missing here. I will correct. Because this is lambda by, maybe it is not the lambda by 8, this will be the lambda by 2. This is the lambda by 2, I will correct it. Because this is lambda by 8, lambda by 4, 3 lambda by 8, and this is the lambda by 2. For this these lengths, we are planning to calculate its input impedance for this example. Now here, we have already discussed, we have the two points on the Smith chart. This point is nothing but the short circuit point. And this is nothing but the open circuit point. Here the impedance is infinite and here impedance is zero. Now here for this case, first we will plot the given value of the impedance. In this case something like this. Here we have this transmission line and it is terminated in the open circuit. Means here its input impedance is its load impedance is the infinite, that is open circuit. And we are calculating here the input impedance of this transmission line for the different lengths. Maybe here it is lambda by 4, then 3 lambda by 8, whatever the values are given for that particular case. And in this case, we are traveling towards the generator to calculate. Means on the Smith chart, we have to travel in the clockwise direction. In the clockwise direction in each case. Now here I will start with the first. Here in this case the length of the transmission line is lambda by 8. For this lambda by 8 we have traveled by that particular distance, and here we are reading out its coordinates. Its coordinates gives us, the value of the sending end impedance for this particular length of the transmission line is minus j1, because this value is a j minus, because it is at the lower half portion of the Smith chart. Then if we are going for second length of the transmission line, which is lambda by 4, in this case, for this particular transmission line, we are coming at this end. And what is this end? This end is the short circuit end. Means here, we will get its input impedance as a zero value, ZS2 is equal to zero. For third transmission line, which is having the length of the 3 lambda by 8, we will read out its coordinates. And its coordinates are somewhere here, which is plus J1, Here, this is the sending end impedance of the open circuited transmission line, terminated open circuited transmission line having the length of the 3 lambda by 8. Its input impedance will be, which is ZS3 here in this case, which is plus J1. And finally, for the transmission line having the length of lambda by 2. Lambda by 2 is nothing but we are coming at the same point, and its input impedance of such transmission line will be same as the termination impedance, which is nothing but the open circuit impedance, which is ZS4 is coming to be infinite. Means these are the simple tricks to be used for the calculation of the sending end impedance if the load impedance of the transmission lines are given. This is the third video. Regarding these calculations. In the fourth video, I will discuss regarding the calculations of load impedance. Load impedance, if the different parameters of the transmission lines are given, and then I will deal with the calculation of the single stub matching and double stub matching in the successive videos. And for this particular presentation or video, this much is from my